So, Angular 18 was released, and I took this as an opportunity to create and release a big update for my Angular the Complete Guide course. And actually, I already announced an update to this course last year when Angular 17 was released, and I did start working on that update back then, but of course, updates take time because quality is important to me. And in addition, Angular 18 also introduced many interesting new features related to signals, which I also wanted to include in this update, which is why I now took this release of Angular 18 as an opportunity to also release that big course update. Now, regarding Angular 18, I will say that I created a separate video on our Academind YouTube channel where I explore that latest Angular version in greater detail and where I explain what exactly changes with Angular 18. You find a link to that video below this video here. In this video here, I instead want to focus on this big course update, and I want to inform you why I created this update, why now, what changes with this update, how you get access to the update, depending on whether you are an existing student or not, how the update is being rolled out, and what it means for you if you already finished the course, if you're currently taking the course, and so on. So let's dive in. Now, regarding Angular 18 and the new features it introduced, I already mentioned that I did create a separate video on that where I dive into Angular 18 in greater detail. Now, regarding the course update, it's worth mentioning that Angular 18 was just one of the reasons that led to this update. I did want to update the course for way longer than that, but with Angular 18, I now feel like Angular is stable enough so that after this update, I don't immediately need to redo the course again, because Angular 18 brought us more important signal-related features and also stabilized some other important new features that were added to Angular over the last couple of months and years, like for example that new template control flow syntax, which, like all these new features, is covered in this brand new course in depth. So why did I create this course update then, and why did I create it now? Well, first of all, it's important to note that I have updated the existing course over all those years. I did add new sections on signals and standalone components, for example, but there also still are many parts that are from the years 2017 to 2020. Now, that's not necessarily a problem because Angular is highly backwards compatible and that old code still works with Angular, and in addition, there also still are many Angular projects out there that use older Angular versions. If you take a look at the NPM download numbers, you'll see that relatively old Angular versions still have lots of downloads, so that old content is important, that old syntax is important. But it was, of course, time for an update. And as mentioned, I now feel like Angular is stable enough and has introduced enough new features so that an update makes sense now. Because I, of course, definitely wanted to include all those new signals-related features and also other new features like the new control flow syntax. And therefore, now feels like the perfect time to redo the course and cover all these new features. But how is this update rolled out now? Well, on Udemy, the new content is inserted into the existing course in front of the old course sections. So if you are enrolled in the course there, you get this update for free automatically, and you can directly jump to these new sections. Or if you're just starting the course, you'll start with the new course automatically because it was inserted in front of that old course. And you could then skip and ignore that old course, for example, but I'll get back to how to use that update a little bit later. So that's Udemy. on Academind Pro. The update is provided as a new separate course into which existing students are enrolled for free, so that you get the update for free there as well. But there you can therefore simply switch between these two courses and therefore decide whether you want to learn the new Angular or the old Angular syntax, which still can be something you might want to do if you're working on a project that uses older Angular versions. But you have the choice on both platforms, therefore. Now, this new course content is of course recorded with all the latest features, so it uses standalone components, signals, the new control flow syntax, and all that right from the start, but I do also cover the old syntax there, like ng modules. I also cover managing data and state without signals there, because that still matters. You should not just use signals everywhere, for example. Instead, as an Angular developer nowadays, it's important to know about all these different options you have, and that's what I tried to achieve with this update and with this course. I cover it all in the new course. That was my goal here, and that's what I do. The old content, the old course, will also stay online because, as mentioned, there are many projects that use this old Angular syntax or older Angular syntax, because there's nothing wrong with it, and that's why this course will stay online, so that if you are working on a project that uses that older syntax, you can simply take that old course. It'll stay there for you. You can use that instead of the new course if you don't care about standalone components and signals that much, for example. Now, it's also worth noting that this update will actually be rolled out in batches. Because, of course, recording takes time and editing, so I'm not fully done with all the new sections yet, because I also was only able to start a couple of weeks, a few months ago maybe, because I needed to wait for some new features to land, some new signal-related features to land, before I was even able to start recording. So that takes time, but also because there are some technical limitations on Udemy, where there is a maximum lecture number, which I can't go beyond. So I have to make sure that I don't insert too much new content at the same time. I might have to remove some redundant old content first. So that's why I'm inserting the content in batches as well. And of course, I also don't want to break student progress too much on Udemy, because whenever I insert new content, of course, the progress kind of is reset to some extent, and there's nothing I can do about that. Udemy doesn't give me a better way of providing free course updates, but that's another reason why I want to do that in batches and make my communication regarding these updates very clear. Now, the first batch, which is all about the Angular Essentials, so a couple of new sections that explore the Angular Essentials in depth, is released today. It's already live. And there you learn all about these essential Angular features like components, standalone components, state management, signals, services, control flow syntax. You learn all about that in depth already in that first batch, which is already live. The second batch will go live on June 17th, and there I'll add plenty of deep dive sections where we dive deeper into components, directives, services, change detection, and much more. So that will be another huge batch which will be released on that date. And then there will be a third and probably final batch where I will also delete some redundant old sections which aren't needed anymore to add more sections on testing, for example, animations, which I haven't recorded yet. And I don't know the exact date yet, but of course, I'll communicate this in advance once I know when that final batch will be released. That's the plan. Of course, things can change, but that's the plan. That's how the update will be rolled out. And therefore, the last question is, how do you get access to that new content? And as I already mentioned, existing students get access for free, because on Udemy, the new content is inserted into the existing course in front of the old content. on Academine Pro. It's a separate course into which existing students are enrolled for free. And as also mentioned before, the old course will stay online. Now, what does this mean for you? How should you continue with the course? Well, if you're already done with the course, if you already took it, you can, of course, ignore the new course. You can ignore it because I did add sections on standalone components and signals to the course in the past already. So you already did learn about these features and therefore you might not care about the new course. But you can, of course, also, for example, go through the essentials section again so that you get a quick overview of modern Angular and its core features. That would be one option. Ultimately, of course, you can take that updated content in whatever way you want. You can ignore it entirely. You can watch it entirely. It really is up to you. Now, if you're currently taking the course, you can either restart with the new course if you're in relatively early stages of the course, or also ignore it. And then also maybe just take the parts that are most interesting to you, like that essentials section or any other section that sounds interesting to you. That is really up to you in the end. Now, if course progress matters to you, you can of course mark the new content as completed manually on Udemy by ticking the boxes if you want to ignore it and you still want to get the 100% course progress. Or if you can't change the course progress manually because then you're some kind of Udemy business enrollment, then you can of course at least watch the new content at double speed or whichever content you are ignoring so that you can go through it quickly. Unfortunately, there's nothing I can do about that because I have no influence on how that platform works. And Udemy doesn't give me any better way of providing updates for free like this. So yeah, that's what I have to do. Now, if you haven't started the course yet, you can, of course, simply go through the course lecture by lecture right from the start, and you'll automatically take the new updated course, therefore, and you can then ignore the old course unless you know that you'll be working on a project that uses an older Angular version, which is not unlikely. In that case, you might want to take the old course instead or take it in addition. So there is lots of flexibility there, which also was my goal and which is also something I can't really avoid because Angular does have all these different versions and features. And with the course, I'm just trying to cover it all for all the students that might be working on all those different projects with all those different versions. But yeah, that's the course update. I did now release the first batch. I'm working hard on getting that second batch ready, and I hope you'll get a lot out of this updated course. If anything's unclear regarding that update, please reach out in the Udemy Q&A board or our Academine Pro Q&A channels if you are enrolled there, and I'll of course do my best to help you there. So I hope you enjoyed the update.